This is the Soul-Filled Sisterhood Podcast, and I'm your host, Nicole Burgess, licensed marriage and family therapist and an empowerment mentor for women. The information shared in this podcast is not a substitute, nor is it to convey professional, psychological, financial, or medical advice. If you could use such services, please seek them out from someone you trust. Now here is today's episode. Episode 62. Well, welcome. If you are not on my email list, I'm going to encourage you to go out to NicoleBurgessCoaching.com/mindfulness, and you can get some free meditations for you to download and help keep you up to date regarding my self-care summit that is going to be in October. It's actually called Self-Care Summit, Improve Your Bottom Line and Your Personal Life. It's really geared towards those of you who are entrepreneurs, and my guest today is actually going to be part of the summit. So again, go out to NicoleBurgessCoaching.com/mindfulness, and that will get you the meditations, but also get you signed up on my email list. Now, here is today's episode. Well, welcome, sisters. I am so excited about my next guest. Today, I have on Amanda Walker. She is a health style coach who empowers women to feel amazing naked. She is the creator of the Feeling Amazing Naked program and the Feel Amazing Naked podcast, and the blogger behind awalkmyway.com. Amanda has overcome a life of yo-yo dieting and using food to cope with her emotions to create total food freedom for herself. She has now guided thousands of men and women to conquer the fear and confusion that was once keeping them stuck. Amanda uses a holistic, no BS approach to coaching and blends strategy, skill, and mindset to help clients unearth the root causes of their struggles with food, body, and mind to help them create the life they crave. She is passionate about challenging clients to create more time in their life for healthy living and giving them tools to get out of their own way to lead their fullest life possible. Amanda is also a mom of two, a wife to a fellow entrepreneur, and coaches CrossFit to stay actively involved in the fitness community. So Amanda, I just want to say thank you so much for being on today.
Thank you for having me. Excited to chat more.
Yay. So share with my listeners, what got you into this work to be a health style coach?
Absolutely. So I've been in the kind of group fitness and health space since I was young, in my early 20s, teaching group fitness. And I kind of started my professional career after graduate school. And I was a teacher, physiology and anatomy teacher, biology teacher, coached, etc. When I had my second child, who's now 8, my health needed some attention. I was experiencing some autoimmune changes. So I kind of dove into the food space more directly and focused on a lot and learning a lot about food quality and furthering my education. And then kind of learning more about food quantity and focusing heavily on working with clients on the food department. And there was this kind of root issue that kept coming up, and we were, really focusing in on, what are you eating? When are you eating it? And I realized those are definitely not the conversations we need to be having, because the root causes for what were keeping clients from creating a sustainable lifestyle really had nothing to do with the food. So That's when I began to kind of doing my own market research and education, and really became fascinated and geeking out on geeking out on the lifestyle component and the mindset component and understanding our brain and habit formation, so that the food part really becomes easy when you work on those underlying root cause issues.
Well, and I love that. And just so you know, ladies, I was having a conversation before I hit record for today's episode with Amanda, and I just loved her passion that came through when she was talking about the science behind some of these things. So I'm like, it's like truly geeking out on this stuff. It's wonderful to see. So I love that you were doing that. And it's fascinating, right? I think for some of my listeners, I know they're in midlife, and I am included in that group. But it's, you talked on your podcast and before, where it's the quality versus quantity, and autoimmune stuff can come up based on some of the things that we are putting in our body. And if we're not mindful or know anything about it, it impacts that. So would you mind sharing just a little bit more about, like, what do you mean when it's quality versus quantity, and what does it mean to actually eat clean? Some of the things that you talk about.
Oh gosh, this question excites me because I was reading this article and it just brought out this really crazy, you know, kind of paradox to me is we as women are likely the most educated and powerful we've ever been. And yet we are the, like, single-handedly greatest victims to dieting culture and misinformation when it comes to food and, you know, detoxes and cleanses and these, you know, magic supplements are very enticing because we're moving through life fast and that quick fix seems like it's going to get us there. And so I see women all the time just victims to this constant quick fix. And my, you know, my anthem is slow it down and do it the root way, you know, start at the bottom and work your way so you are no longer a victim to misinformation and you're debunking some of those diet myths. And so one of those myths is that just by eating clean, you will lose weight. Mm-hmm. And I think that's a really important one to understand because the term clean is very subjective. What you deem as clean eating might be very different than what I deem as clean eating. And so for me, food quality is the ingredients, right? And the whole foods that you're putting into your body. And you can eat all of the, you know, highest quality foods and still not have weight loss because there's still this energetic component of energy in and energy out of the body that's necessary, that must be adjusted in order to see a shift in weight loss and actual physical body composition changes. And so I hear from women, well, I'm eating clean and nothing's happening. And what they don't see is that some of those cleaner foods, or let's say whole foods, avocados, nuts, seeds, are very calorically dense. And that's fantastic if you work those in, but also you sometimes need somebody to evaluate the energetic component of it to help you see that they're both important for different reasons.
Oh, that makes much more sense now. I've not actually ever heard it in that form before. And it's funny because as you were talking, I'm like, huh, I also believed in that myth. It's like, if you eat clean, you lose weight, but there is a different component regarding also the caloric piece of it, of like the quantity that comes into that, that plays into that. It's like, I don't know. It's like, it's simple. Yeah. It's like, oh, that makes a lot of sense.
Absolutely. And I think that, you know, there's this fine line we walk between, I don't subscribe to a dieting culture, but I do subscribe to living intentionally and being aware. And, there's so much, you know, hype out there of, body positivity, which I want every woman to love their body, but that looks different for everyone. Yes. And you also have to be healthy on the inside. And you have to know that those are all in alignment for sustainable progress for you.
Yeah. And you've hit it. All of our bodies are unique and different. And it is being happy with who you are and where you are. And so it's not only like what you're talking, the root cause, it's looking at what you're putting in your body, but also what you're telling yourself. So that mindset, the belief system really makes a big impact regarding the health style, the whole approach regarding your health as well.
Yeah. And a little bit of background too is, you know, I went into a space that I was very consumed by, let's say, dieting and being at the lowest weight ever. And I got there and I was very, very unfulfilled. Mm-hmm. And that was one of my own personal experiences that make me really, really passionate about doing the inside work first. And then the outside work kind of follows because I did the outside work first and got there. And I was like, oh man, this is it. There's got to be more to this, right? All of a sudden the scale gods didn't descend upon me and start singing and chanting, "You're amazing." I was like, oh, this is really not what I expected. And so I want women to just see that the way we, there's no happiness ahead of us that is not already inside of us, but you have to really do both sides of the work to feel confident in your skin.
Well, I love that. And again, it's the lessons you learn for yourself. It's now being able to help other women. It's like, well, you don't need to go through the same thing I did. Let's do that slightly different, which is starting from the inside out. So what are some ways, and then we'll kind of go into more of the healthier food stuff, but what are some ways that can help women really start to begin to shift their mindset around their own health and well-being? What are some things that have worked for you that maybe could help some of my listeners?
I think that creating space, you know, everybody's root cause struggles are different. Mm-hmm. And so I think that if you find yourself in a poor relationship with food, is the biggest first step is to cultivate awareness. Mm-hmm. And just asking yourself why, you know, if I find at 8 o'clock every night, I am going on a pantry raid, why are you going on a pantry raid at 4 o'clock? You know, when, you know, depending upon if you have children and the age of your children, I see this a lot with mothers, mm-hmm. Their kids are coming home from school, the stress level's high, they're getting ready for activities and they find themselves eating often. Or at the flip side with entrepreneurial type women, I see them not fueling themselves for performance. And so it's just asking your personal self, what is it? Why am I being held up? And I think when you pause for reflection, which most of us aren't doing, then there is some light bulb moments that will happen that kind of create a direction for you to start to do some work on yourself when it comes to health.
Well, I love that too. It's so much about the getting curious. When you do create that space and that space for self-reflection, it's like so much information can come up. But as women, we need to create that. Otherwise, we can't do any of these changes in these areas that we're wanting, especially in the health area. And I know for some of the moms that I've worked with, again, I'm not a health coach, but I've watched them say, yeah, well, the kids come home and it's like it does. The stress level comes up and almost the franticness of mm-hmm. all the activities that are scheduled. It's like, we got to go here and do this. And some of it, I'm like, well, is there planning that goes involved with like what's being intentional? What do we have for those snacks? Or are we really hungry? Or is it truly, are we thirsty instead?
Yes. And I think you hit it perfectly, was that those environments that feel chaotic can be, you know, the overwhelm and those, you know, level 10 emotionally flooding moments mm-hmm. that cause you, you know, eating all the chips and salsa or whatever, can really be eliminated by shifting and putting in practices in your life that help you become a proactive eater. And so I'm constantly trying to teach the women that I work with that when we live life in a reactive manner, we eat in a reactive manner. And that is, if there's no environment for success, if you don't have a plan in place before those stressors come into play, then you aren't going to make great choices. And as you mentioned, I coach CrossFit, and I love this analogy because I think it speaks to people a little bit more. But when I'm coaching an athlete, and maybe their form is not spot on, the worst time for me to try to coach them is in the middle of a workout when their fight or flight is at mm-hmm. its highest and the stresses they're experiencing are really high. They're literally in survival mode. The time I must teach them is when they're away from that, either before a workout or after a workout, after everything's kind of come back to center. And so that is the important piece, is that investing in creating an environment of success. So when those high stress moments, those fight or flight moments come in, you can think from your rational brain and make choices that support you because you've cultivated all this stuff ahead of time for you to do that.
Oh, I love that. And again, I've never made that connection. I'm just laughing to myself. I'm like, seriously, you've never known that before? But that, yeah, to get feedback on your form during a workout, you're not in the right mind space for you to have that. It's either before or after. So I love that, yeah, it's like, and you're in the moment, it's like, wait till that chaos calms down. And you said you're back in the front part of your brain, basically, is where mm-hmm. that is. And now you can go, okay, what didn't work? What do I want to do differently? Or what part of that form do I need to modify or adjust? And then you go from there. It's not beating yourself up like, well, I screwed up again, the all or nothing kind of thinking. It's more of just like, hey, that didn't work. So let me do a small pivot. Here we go. Go forward.
Yes, 100% agreed.
I love that. Well, share just a little bit then. Let's pivot just a little bit. So as they're looking, as women are exploring a little bit, again, getting curious about their mindset and their beliefs around all of this, what are some ways you talked about, again, on your podcast and some of the blogs that you've written regarding, again, I'm going to go back to, I've read this over and over. It's like, what, it's so expensive to eat healthier. It's too expensive for me to buy the quote, good stuff. And you are also debunking that myth as well. So would you mind sharing a little bit more, like how women can start to go about truly bringing more healthier foods into the home so that they can eat healthier?
Yeah, absolutely. I do believe it's a myth. And there's a blog post I wrote that kind of compared like feeding your family at McDonald's, a family of four at McDonald's versus making, you know, a homemade version of Sloppy Joe's. And we can come up with every freaking excuse in the book to say living a healthy life is hard. Mm-hmm. And if you choose to believe it's hard, guess what? It's going to be hard. Or you can choose to understand that the greatest single investment you can make in your life is your health, yeah, and that it bleeds into every aspect of your life. And so perhaps the investment initially in understanding isn't in, or the investment isn't actually in money, but in understanding and time. And so it becomes a scapegoat, the expensive part, you know, the budget part becomes a scapegoat. And I think that what we were just touching on is if you create a plan, and you have a grounding day practice, which is something I teach to the girls in my program and my one-on-one clients. When we refine that practice and you have a lot of clarity at home before you even step foot into the grocery store, then you can streamline the prep, you know, the preparation process and the budget, because you have a game plan and you're not buying a whole bunch of junk that you don't need to. And when you build in a night of leftovers, then everything gets used up in your refrigerator and you're not throwing food out. Mm-hmm. You know, and some other random simple tips are, you know, I love to buy certain foods, that high quality whole foods that are on, you know, I watch for the sale and I stock up on those. I freeze them, yep, when they're available, like, you know, wild caught salmon or, you know, great quality chicken or whatever. Mm-hmm. And so I freeze them when they're on sale so that I can pull them out of my freezer. I love to shop the clearance whole food areas at, yes, the back or the side of every grocery store is usually a little, you know, bin or refrigerator section of that stuff that needs like used up right away. So I'll reroute, you know, my plan for the week if I happen to step foot in the grocery store and there's a lot of good stuff in that area, just to be more budget friendly. So I think the, you know, is it true it costs more? I actually don't agree to that. Mm-hmm. I think that you can make some amazing whole food meals for your family for far less than you'd shop at McDonald's if you choose to believe that.
Well, and I think you've really hit upon something key, Amanda, that our health is the biggest investment. So what happens is, as we know, if we keep eating all McDonald's, you're going to have ramifications for your health down the road. Maybe it's not tomorrow, maybe it's not 30 days, but 5 years, 10 years, whatever it may be. Oftentimes it's even quicker than that. You know, you're sick more often. You just can't bounce back as quick. It can impact other health issues that when you're not eating in the healthier way, that you're going to spend thousands of dollars due to just our healthcare costs of where they are, mm-hmm, right now. It's like versus, you know what, if I invest here because it's more nutrient rich, then my body is more satisfied and I don't necessarily have the brain fog or the cloudiness or anything because I'm eating healthier. And you're also role modeling again to your children to really invest in your own health.
Absolutely. And you would bring up the point that was coming to my mind is more is caught than taught when it comes to our kids. And mm-hmm, if you didn't experience a healthy lifestyle as a child, then we get the opportunity to rewrite that story for our kids, mm-hmm, and lead them and help them see not that health has nothing to do with a scale weight or fitting into a particular dress size. It's about you and really your longevity of life. And I want my kids to see personally from the beginning that the way I want to feel is directly correlated with the foods that I put in my body. And I cannot tell you how many women I began work with and they tell me, you know, energetically they feel, you know, powerless. They feel no energy. They're depressed. They have poor attitudes. And I always show them, I have this kind of law of attraction, kind of spinoff that's related to food and how energetically how you want to feel. And there is no coincidence that when we fill our body with real whole foods that we feel, F-E-E-L, differently, because the two go hand in hand. It's like, if you want to show up bigger in life, 100%, it starts with the foods that you put into your body, which has you feeling better, more confident, likely losing weight. And then you're not experiencing those spin-offs of maybe pain in the joints, right? Or GI issues. And so many women begin with me and they're telling me, well, I have all these things. Yeah, let's work on the food and you're going to see a profound shift in all those other things and medications we can even get off of.
Yeah, it really is. So it's mind-blowing that what we eat impacts everything in our life, because it starts within our bodies, and then it impacts the mind, impacts, you know, inflammation in our, mm-hmm. literally in our brain and in our organs, that it really is correlated to what it is we're putting in our body as well. So I love that you're helping women, like you said, rewrite the story about what they have thought about their own body, what they've thought about food, that it's possible to truly shift that and change that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I'm kind of curious, sometimes I'll ask my guests, you know, different questions after we've talked for a little bit, but who has been some of the people who've really inspired you over your life that really has helped get you to where you are today? Who are some of those people that have inspired you?
Yeah, I absolutely think, you know, my parents are at the core of that. They've always kind of got my back wherever whatever path I have taken, and although I don't think they fully grasp exactly because entrepreneurship is just like you get to build what you want. Mm-hmm. They're cheering me on, even though they don't get quite the real understanding of my coaching, because it's, you know, not typical brick and mortar.
Yeah.
My husband is really the driving force behind my support. He sees my vision, and on those days where I'm like, oh man, I want it to happen faster, or today wasn't that day, or whatever, he reminds me that I'm totally enough and it's coming if I keep taking action. So I think the three of them, and now I have like the little people in my life, my daughter who's almost 10 and my son who's almost 8, they will just say the most amazing thing. So they'll just remember like, oh, you had a speaking event, or you're recording a podcast. How did it go? And I just think it's so cool, because they get to see that it's not, life doesn't have to go to, you know, you don't have to go to college and be traditional. You can create whatever you want. So,
yeah. Oh, I love that. Well, ladies, to find out more about Amanda, you can go out to her website, which is awalkmyway.com. And again, I'm going to have this in the show notes. She is also offering two different gifts. One is of journal prompts, and that the links are going to be on the show notes. And the journal prompt, she says, you do not have to do all at once. You know, you can take them one at a time, but it's really helping you kind of shift your belief system and your mindset around your health and your weight and what you're eating. The other thing she has for you is some free at-home workouts. And she said there's a video if you're trying to look for some form or not understanding what the move is, that you can watch the video. But stuff, you don't need to go to a gym, you don't need to have any equipment. But she's offering both of those things for free, and those links will be on the website. So Amanda, thank you so much for being on today, and truly for doing what you're doing in our world and making a change and helping women seriously just embrace who they are as a woman, but also their health. And I love your little slogan, you know, feel amazing naked, just because I think that's such a thing for so many women, that they're just not happy with their body, and you're helping make a big change in our world. So thank you.
Thank you. I mean, that's why I call my podcast and program Feel Amazing Naked, because I think that there's so much ambiguity there about feeling amazing naked on the outside, but really it's all about how you feel on the inside. And so I want more women to feel that way.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, and it comes across too with the passion that you have for this. And again, sharing your own journey and how you have flipped things around, and sharing your lessons you've learned with others so that they can do it quicker and not have to struggle on their own. So thank you.
Great. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for listening. And as I said earlier in the podcast, go out to NicoleBurgessCoaching.com/mindfulness and download your free meditations and get on my email list, so you can stay up to date with all my latest offerings, podcasts, and other things that I do not talk about in the podcast. See you there.